Welcome to yet another Waec series, guys. I decided to continue with this series after I discovered that my how to pass Waec video recently got to 10k views. That is so insane, guys. I think now it's at 10,509 views, and it has been blowing my mind ever since, as it has gotten me about 605 subscribers in the short span of time. So guys, in today's video, I'm going to be talking about how to pass Waec practicalS excellently. If this is something that you would love to see, especially if you're in the sciences and you're taking practicalS, I advise you all to watch this video till the very end. So how to pass Waec coming up. So guys, now for me, I took some Waec practicalS. I took physics, chemistry, bio, and I think those were the three practicalS that I took. So I'm going to be talking about them especially, but I'm going to try as much as I can to give you a bit of idea about how to go about other Waec practicalS. Waec, as you know, is one very important examination that you take before coming into uni, and this exam is particularly important because it serves as an O-level result. Aside that, one of the most important aspects of this huge exam is your practicalS. Your practicalS constitute a lot of marks. I can't remember honestly how many marks it used to cost in our time. I wrote my Waec, it was in 2018, 2019. I can't really remember. It was in 2018 that I wrote my Waec examination, and I had a very, very good result. Like I said, if you want me to put out that video on my Waec result, please leave a comment down below. Subscribe to this channel, because I noticed that out of those 10k people that viewed my previous how to pass Waec video that went viral, I think 80%+ of them were not my subscribers. They were not subscribed. They just watched and left. Please do not just watch and leave this video. Subscribe. So guys, when it comes to Waec practicalS for physics, I think there's nothing much to be scared of, because it is very niche specific, in the sense that it is not like a wide range. It's usually mechanics. Look, Waec gives you three practicalS in physics and asks you to pick two of them. These things I'm saying are subject to change, because it had, like I said, I wrote my exam in 2018 and this is 2021. A lot of things have changed within the space of time. So I'll ask you to ask somebody that's taking this exam whether it has changed or whatever. But from my time, it used to be three practicalS in physics. You are given mechanics, you're given optics, you're given electricity, and you're asked to pick two of them and perform them. So usually most students pick mechanics and electricity, because optics can get really complex. Like when it comes to the triangular prism, it depends on the kind of optics question that is given. Sometimes, for me now in university, I'm seeing optics as very easy, but back then we found optics to be very difficult. We didn't like drawing the prisms, we didn't like anything associated with looking through the glass and pinning. We hated any of those stuff. So we usually went with mechanics and electricity. So one thing I did was, for the mechanics and electricity practicalS, I went to my past question booklet. You need a past question booklet if you want this to work. I went to my past question booklet and I studied the past question booklet pertaining to mechanics and electricity. If you get a normal regular physics past question, there's also practicalS in it. So what I'll advise you to do is to revise all the questions under, if you're like me, mechanics and electricity. You have to go through it, like every single practicalS, starting from the present year, moving from moving backwards, basically. You get what I mean? Like 2021, 2020, 2020, 2019, 2018, like moving backwards like that from the present year, and revise the various practicalS. Look at how the tables are drawn. You need to know, because I know an essential part of physics practicalS is the tabulation, presentation of the tables, and the calculation too with graphs. So I'll advise you to look through all the practicalS. The graphs might be slightly different, but know how your graph is supposed to look like if you're doing mechanics. Mostly, most of the mechanics questions given, I think, are usually pendulum, where they ask you to dispense the bulb from some certain height, or knife edge, where you have to balance a meter rule on a knife edge. I think those are the two. Sometimes mechanics can go all the way crazy. That's why I advise you that even if you're going to be studying mechanics and electricity, you should also revise optics. Like look into optics in case one thing leads to another, you have to do optics. So go over it, but study all the practical past question, the tabulation and the graph, and know some of the certain criteria that are essential for your practicals, like writing the constant, the unit. All of those things for physics are very, very important. And if you go through past questions, you would realize what Waec wants to see on your question paper. So guys, for the next one is chemistry. When it comes to chemistry is a bit broad, kind of, but it is also narrow, because the questions that are usually given in chemistry is quantitative analysis and qualitative analysis. Quantitative analysis has to do with like calculations, and the most popular form of practical under this kind of experiment or under this practical is titration. They give you some certain samples and they ask you to titrate. I'll advise you to also go through the previous years, understand your indicator in case they ask you in a weak acid strong base, what kind of indicator is used, like understand indicators. That also helps a lot. Know when you're to use phenolphthalein, know when to use metal red and other indicators. I've forgotten some of them. Other indicators, know when to use them, and also your tabulations, also know how the titration table is meant to look like and the values. I think when it comes to chemistry values, it is very easy for you to manipulate. Don't say I didn't see any of those things. Whenever you carry out your titration, or yeah, your titration, the difference should be plus or minus 0.02. If it's something like if it's 2.5 to 2.51, you're within range. If it's 2.5 to 2.54, you're still kind of within range. If it's 2.52 and you're getting something like 2.60, like you are so far from range, like you get, the difference is really large. So I advise you all to check the accepted range. If it's zero, I think my time is plus or minus 0.02 or 0.03, one of them. So what I normally did was what I normally do even up until now in uni is whenever I carry out a practical under titration and I notice my values are having high range, I tend to either carry out the practicals again or know that I'm just basically wrong. Like from that, I already know that this, my practicals is messed up, it's wrong already. So some people tend to manipulate values. Don't say I told you. But some people tend to manipulate and change the values to something closer. But yeah, that is one of chemistry practical. That is the quantitative analysis. Now on to qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis is the broad one. It involves cramming. I'm going to tell you the honest truth with qualitative analysis. But it's kind of easier when you're doing the practical. Because when you see green color, something changing to green, you know that it's basically iron 2 that is there. If it's brown, it's iron 3. Like, if the color, you need to know the color change that is associated with a metal, with a non-metal, with that is cation, anion, because you'll be given a whole wide range of salts, and you're going to be asked what salt is this. From, they're going to tell you what to do. So normally they give you procedures on what to do, but they don't tell you the sample, the salt sample that is there. So it's from your procedures that you would know what kind of salt or what kind of anion or cation is present, basically. So it's from, you have to look into the practicals, go to your past questions, like I said, and review all the chemistry practicals, knowing the various color change and the metal or non-metal associated with it. And sometimes there are some specific practicals, like when they ask you to test for gases. I know when I'm seeing lime water changing milky, that is CO2 that is present, that is carbon dioxide. So whenever I see that in my question, I immediately go with CO2. I don't even need to carry it. As far as I see, turns lime water milky, I already know the gas that is present. But yeah, so there are some kind of techniques you can use. Sometimes the practicals itself can tell you the kind of gas. Is it collected upward? Is it upward displacement or downward displacement? Can tell you the kind of gas. If it's is it changing litmus paper from red to blue or blue to red, you know, some of these tests, you should know them and know what they signify. And I advise you to look into your past question, know all the color changes for metals, that is for anions, and that is for cations and anions, that is positive charges and negative, like just know all of them. And yeah, in case that is basically it for qualitative analysis, because you're going to be given a lot of salt and you're going to be asked to test for cations, anions, and all of those stuff. So guys, for the next one is biology. Biology is kind of easier if you get help somehow. For my practicals, my biologist was kind enough to let us know the specimens. So on biology, I do not even tell you the specimen, but I'm sure even if you go on Facebook and you join on Facebook groups, you actually know the specimen. Somehow you find out the specimen, because it's not only your school, and the specimens are kind of general. All the schools are doing the same practicals and they have the same specimen. So you see why even if your biology does not tell you, you certainly find out somehow. So once you know the specimen, you know if it is fruits they're giving you, or they're giving you bones, or they're giving you whatever they're giving you, guys. Sometimes, most times, they like to give fruits and they ask you what form of placentation is this. Is this a drupe? Is this a what kind of, basically, those are some of the, is it over placentation? They kind of give you like different fruit and they ask you the kind of placentation, what kind of classification of the fruit, what kind of classification it belongs to. Or yeah, for my, I think for bio, for my neco bio, I can't remember whether it was neco or why, they actually gave us bone. I think it was the femur bone that they gave us, femur, and they asked us questions under it. So yeah, you basically, if you can get your biologist to tell you the specimen, sometimes most biologists like to tell specimen because biology is broad. So when, if you can get idea of the specimen, your work becomes easier. What I did was, after finding out my specimen, I went to my past question and I looked for everything associated with that specimen. Look for everything associated, because there's high probability, there's high chances, that's not the first time they're bringing that specimen. So you should look at all your past questions and read out questions associated with that specimen. All the possible questions that can come out from that specimen. So go to your past question. It is time for you to work. It's time for you to ransack the whole past question. Search as hard as you can for the questions associated with it and read up on it. Read up on the specimen and learn. Also abide by some biology rules. I feel like a lot of people don't tell us this, like no double lines. Your pencil shouldn't be thick. So thick, label on one side, and always write your magnification. Which other rule? There are a lot of biology rules. I advise you to go on Google and like Google the rules for biological specimens, so that when you're drawing them, you are aware of these rules and it helps you gather more marks. Even up until now, in my biology practicals I do in university, we still abide by this rule. So I advise you all to Google these rules and know them, know it by heart, and be ready to implement it. So I do, these were some of the practicals I took in my time. I'm sure now there are so many practicals, there's even computer practicals. Computer practicals, I think most of the time they'll ask you to use some of these packages, whether it's PowerPoint or some of these packages basically. So I'll advise you all to get your past questions on this experiment. Like, go through all the... Normally, practicals are not very... How will I put it? They are not like the whole... They do not constitute the bulk of the past question booklet. They are just a little section of it. So it's something that you can actually go through. So I advise you to get your past question and begin studying. Study all what you can get under the practicals and... You are good to go. So guys, that is how I was able to conquer my Waec practicals. I'll advise you all to also do the same, because I'm sure it's going to help you all. So don't forget to subscribe, like, and stick around if you love all this content and even lifestyle content. Until next time, guys. Bye.